Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to show you guys this watercolor effect that I just fell in love with. I'm showing you guys here a safety bit that I purchased online, on eBay. I'm removing all the old polish. As you can see, the set that I had was in desperate need of a new fill. And I dusted off, I also thinned out the acrylic nail. I thinned it out because we're going to apply another colored acrylic on top and we don't want it too thick. As you can see here, I'm using a 220 grit file. I have these for sale in my online store. I like this grit because it's not too harsh onto the natural nail, and I just took the shine off of the natural nail, the new growth, and I dusted off, but that's not enough. I always recommend to use alcohol because alcohol cleans and disinfects, and it just leaves the nail plate ready for the acrylic application and it absorbs the products much better. Here I'm applying one layer of dehydrator. We want to remove any excess oil that the nail has, and right here I'm applying primer, two coats of primer. I'm gonna start with once a medium-sized wet bead close to the cuticle area, but not that close, and always being careful to not touch the cuticle area at all. I'm just going to lightly brush down, clean the sides, making sure my work is clean. I'm going to apply a second bead, a little bit smaller, onto the cuticle area, and I have my finger bent down at a 45 degree angle. As you can see, this step is gonna help you so much to not touch your cuticle area. Sometimes the acrylic touches the cuticle area and that's what causes premature lifting. So I always remember to just angle that finger down. It makes a world of a difference. Now I'm just filling in wherever I see the nail needs thickness. And I'm going to check, as you can see sideways, the stress area, which is the middle part. It's where all the strength of the nail is, and especially with nails that are this long, we need strength. So I just made sure I put one more bead there. I cleaned off my work. I did the rest of my nails. I filed, I buffed. And right here, I'm using my alcohol again. And I'm using my Soft Landings wipes that I love so much to clean off all the excess dust. And I'm using Funky Geneva from Oh So Dollish Polishes. You can find them on Instagram. This is the second coat that I am putting onto the nail. I love this color. It's like a beautiful lavender, just perfect color for spring, and I just love it. And this is a French brush. I recommend that everybody that loves doing nails, you have to have this in your kit, because they're so inexpensive. You can find them anywhere. I also carry them in my online store, but you can really find them anywhere. They're very inexpensive and it makes a world of a difference in your nail art, because it makes it look so, the end result looks so clean. And that's, I always tell you in all the videos, that that's what's gonna make you different from everyone else, a very clean cuticle area. I use this white polish from Fantasy Nails, but it can be any polish, any brand, doesn't really matter. Now we're gonna do the watercolor effect. You have to let the white polish completely dry. I'm showing you that I bought this polish thinner at Sally's Beauty Supply for $7.99, which is a great deal because you never really need a lot. That's just a small square nail art brush. This is Wet Cement from Wet n Wild. From Julie G, this is Birthday Suit. And again, Funky Geneva from Oh So Dollish Polishes. Another tip that I'd love to give you guys, it has helped me so much, is using foil paper. When you're gonna put polish on something, make sure it's foil paper. Don't use plastic or don't use paper, because the polish seems, it dries out faster. This tip was given to me by a professional nail artist, and I've done it ever since because it really makes a world of a difference. Here I applied about 3 to 4 drops of polish thinner. Make sure it's polish thinner. Don't use acetone, because acetone is gonna change the color completely. Polish thinner just thins it out. Okay, with the brush, I'm going to dip in there and I'm just going to tap all over the nail. That's why it's important to put a white base under so all the colors can really pop. Okay, so next I I clean the brush in acetone, and then I put a couple drops of polish thinner in this pink polish birthday suit from Julie G. And now I'm going to go over it just in random areas, just tap, tap, tap. Now I'm doing the same with the wet cement from Wet n Wild. I love this color. I just wanted to give it like a contrast with a darker polish, but not too dark. This one still falls like a soft dark color, if that makes any sense. What I did is I repeated those steps. I did another coat. I did another one of the purple, the pink, and then the wet cement. I did everything twice. So it can, you know, pop out more. You can leave it once if you want it light, or you can do it again so it can, you know, be darker. I let it dry. You have to let it dry, okay? Then I have this gold striper that I got like for a dollar or two, I don't even remember where. And I just put them in random spots. When it completely dried, this is the secret with applying UV gel over any polish. You have to let it completely dry 100%, or else it's gonna crack. So you have to let it completely dry. I applied my UV Shine from Nova Ink. And the reason I'm applying the rhinestones with glue this time, I usually apply them with builder gel. As many of you know, I have a video specially on that. If you want to go check it out, I'll leave the link in the description bar. I applied these Swarovski crystals with glue because I applied this set of nails right before I was gonna move, and I knew that I was gonna be moving boxes, so I knew I was gonna take off my nails pretty soon. So I didn't want long lasting rhinestones. I wanted to take them off, you know, easily. So when I want my rhinestones to, you know, not last that long, I adhere them with nail glue. When I want them to last a very, very long time, like on my clients and on myself, I'll do it with builder gel. So now I went ahead to put a little bit of glue on my pinky finger, and I just applied. The sizes of these Swarovski crystals, I believe, are 12, 10, and 7. I believe that those are the sizes, if I'm not mistaken. And just simply like this, I did the same thing on the pinky and the thumb. On the right hand, I didn't do the same thing. The only thing I did the same was the pinky and the thumb. The middle finger, I left it just with the watercolor so it can, you know, I can show off that effect a little bit. Now I put nail glue in random places around the rhinestones, making sure I don't touch the top of the rhinestones. And I just applied these micro beads, and I love the end result. I really hope you guys loved it too. Thank you so, so much for watching.